Sigmatropic rearrangements are identified by their order, ij, and the easiest way to think about this is by looking at a couple of examples and recognizing that this ij notation comes by identifying how far the sigma bond migrates. So in order to identify how far the sigma bond migrates, we first need to identify which sigma bond is it that's undergoing a migration. So let's first look at this Claisen rearrangement. The Claisen rearrangement involves a vinyl ether, that's this part, connected to an allylic ether. That would be the bottom part, the allylic ether. Now, if we notice in the reactant, there's a bond present between oxygen and CH2, but that bond has gone in the product, and so that must be the bond that breaks. Where does that sigma bond migrate to? Well, if we look, these CH2 groups initially were unconnected in the reactant, but now they're connected in the product. So the migration must go toward the positions that are labeled 3 and 3 prime. Where do those labels come from? What we do in assigning the order IJ is to begin by putting 1s at the position of the bond that breaks. And then we number the top half and the bottom half away from the sigma bond that breaks. So a 1 is positioned on oxygen, 2 and 3, until we get to the atom where the sigma bond migrates to. Then on the bottom side, we go from 1 prime to 2 prime until we get to this position 3 prime. The connection is between the 3 and the 3 prime position, meaning that the sigma bond moved over by 2 atoms. We call this a 3-3 sigmatropic rearrangement, and this particular one with this vinyl ether, allylic ether, is known as the Claisen rearrangement. The COPE rearrangement is a hydrocarbon analog of the Claisen rearrangement. It involves a pair of vinyl bonds that undergo the 3-3 sigmatropic rearrangement. The migration is that bond, and so again we number 1, 2, 3 across the top, 1 prime, 2 prime, and 3 prime down along the bottom, because we get to the terminal position where the new sigma bond forms. This is a 3-3 sigmatropic rearrangement, just like the Claisen rearrangement. If we look at the case on the bottom, we'll see that it's a 2-3 rearrangement. How do we come to that conclusion? Well, the bond that breaks is this one. We recognize that there's a CH2 oxygen bond in the reactant that doesn't exist in the product. That bond breaks, where does it migrate to? We can see that there's a new bond that's formed between this atom, this CH connected to R, and the position that is a CH2. The new bond is formed there. So now we number on opposite sides of the bond that breaks 1 and 1 prime, and we continue to number until we get to the terminal positions. The 1 prime goes to 2 prime, and that's the end of the line. And then 1, 2, 3 is the end of the line for the other half. The connection is between positions 2 and 3. We put the smaller number first, and so we have the 2-3 sigmatropic rearrangement. In the next webcast, we'll examine the 1-5 sigmatropic rearrangement, doing a frontier molecular orbital analysis on that reaction.